Welcome to this segment of Mr. Abayomi Says. Hello everyone, this is Mr. Abayomi, broadcasting from the nation's capital in the D.C. suburbs of Fairfax County, Virginia. Today, I want to discuss climate change. There are plenty of people on one side who do not believe this is a real thing. There is a majority of us who do believe this is a real and also clear and present danger. For those who do not believe in the science, I remind them that if they are taking any medications, if they arrive to work in a car or a bus, or are the owner of a smartphone, the same science that makes all these wonderful inventions possible is the exact same science that makes us aware of the catastrophic damage being done to our environment and our planet. Some people really show their ignorance and lack of foresight when, for example, a cold snap hits. What happened to global warming? The total landmass on the lower 48 of the United States makes up 5% of the entire landmass of the entire planet. Add in Alaska, Hawaii, and other U.S. territories, and we're only around 6.5 to 7% of the Earth's total landmass. All the landmasses of the entire U.S. make up a whopping 1.58% of the Earth's total surface. The lesson here is, just because your tiny speck of the planet might be colder than normal, most other areas of the planet are experiencing warmer than normal temperatures. The oceans are getting warmer, the polar caps and glaciers are receding and melting faster than they have since records have been kept. Rare 100 and 500 year storms are becoming the new normal. More extreme weather, longer and prolonged fire seasons and droughts are also occurring planet-wide, not to mention the massive die-offs of both terrestrial and sea-based life forms. Having everyone riding bikes, becoming vegan, and eating a robust diet of alfalfa and dandelion leaves is not the answer either. Today's climate issues require bold new ideas and an out-of-the-box strategies. Cleaner burning vehicles, more efficient power plants, recycling, and cutting gas and methane emissions from cattle are a start, but not the whole entire answer. How we move goods and people around with a smaller carbon imprint is one of the issues that will need to be tackled. Another huge challenge is removing CO2 from the atmosphere. Fortunately for us, nature has many ways of doing this. We are putting a heavy strain on the system, so we need to help support the system. The planet will live on, but it may not be in any condition where it's viable for us to live here. Last I checked, there are no other ways of moving the entire population of this planet or any smaller numbers to another habitable planet. We are stuck here and need to fix this. We have some really smart people out there who have the expertise. I just have some general ideas which I think might move the needle and get us going in the right direction. Some scientists think we have reached a point of no return. I do not believe we have completely fallen off the cliff. I do believe the longer we wait, the worse we will make things more difficult to reverse the damage. There was a paper posted just recently by the University College London. The researchers hypothesized when the Europeans came to the Americas, about 50 to 60 million of the Native Americans were killed due to war and disease. Approximately 15 million acres of cleared agricultural land, or the equivalent landmass of France, was reclaimed and reforested by nature over the next 100 years, which would reduce the amount of CO2 in the atmosphere so much it caused a mini ice age. Researchers saw a dip in CO2 and ice core readings between 1492 and its peak in 1610. I'm not suggesting we start exterminating people or taking anyone's land. That's very bad, and there's a terrible track record of that through world history. We need to look at allocation of resources, in particular planting and water resource management. I think we need to look at areas where we can plant trees where there are none, create river systems where none exist currently, and manage these things on a generational public works international scale like it's never been done before. If done right, it would create a lot of good paying green jobs and put a lot of people to work. We spend enormous amounts of resources pulling crude oil and natural gas out of the ground from underneath the seabed, extracting it from oil shale rocks and piping it through pipelines and sending it into tankers around the globe. Why can't we pull water where there is abundance and send it to where there is drought through pipelines? Water desalinization is inherently expensive and requires a lot of electricity. There are plenty of areas to put up solar panels, build wind farms, and pipe that energy to the desalination plants to purify seawater and refill the underground aquifers that have been drained over time from farming and agricultural use. The excess water could be put into man-made lakes and reservoirs. Imagine working with our Mexican neighbors to the south on a massive international public works project where we created a huge forest in the Rio Grande Valley Desert area, for example. How about in some areas of California, which are always subject to extreme drought? How about a massive international project in an attempt to green the Sahara Desert in an attempt to stave off climate change? Possibilities are limitless. We have satellites in space, with people on the moon, we have rovers on Mars. There are probes millions of miles traveling in space as we speak right now. As a species, we split the atom with enough stockpiled nuclear weapons to destroy the entire surface of the Earth many, many times over. Surely, we have the technical know-how to fight off climate change, to work with nature to make the world a healthier, better place to live for all of us. Bottom line, if we're going to continue to burn fossil fuels at the rate that we are, we need to find a way of removing the CO2 from the atmosphere on a global scale. It has to work for everyone. Everyone has to work towards it. That's the only way that it works. That's all for now. Be well. Do something nice for someone today. God bless, and I bid you peace.